Today, we are going to discuss about a topic in marketing management, that is branding. Okay, branding is a very important term in marketing management. It is a process of creating a unique and long-lasting image for a product of a one seller in the mind of the consumers. Customers choose a product not only on the basis of their wants and the features of the product, but also on the basis of the brand value that they given to a particular product brand. Now we are going to discuss about what you mean by brand. As per American Marketing Association, brand is a name, term, sign, symbol, design, or combination of these terms intended to differentiate the product offered by one seller or a group of sellers from the product offered by the other sellers. Now we are going to discuss about the objectives of branding. The first objective of branding is to remember the product. Second one is deliver the product message. That means through branding activity, the firm delivers a clear message about the product, its features, its quality, its price, etc. to the consumers belonging to the targeted market. Then the third one is reach the target market customers emotionally. Fourth one is increase the familiarity of the product. Through branding activity, the firm make a product familiar in the market. We all are familiar about top brands shirts that are available in the market like Louis Philippe, Van Hussein, etc. Then the last objective is customers' loyalty. That means branding activity help the firm to get brand loyal customers. And brand loyal customers is always an asset to the firm. The next topic that we are going to discuss is the different strategies followed by different marketing firms for branding their product. There are different branding strategies available for a firm to brand their product. The main branding strategies are family branding, corporate branding, individual branding, and combination branding. First of all, we are thinking about what you mean by family branding. Family branding is the process of branding the entire product that should be offered by a firm under a single brand name. That means the entire products that make available by the firm to the market or to the targeted customers in the single brand name. For example, take the case of Johnson & Johnson. Johnson & Johnson introduced several products to the markets in the same brand name, that Johnson & Johnson. The second one is corporate branding. In corporate branding, the firm used the corporate name as its brand name. For example, Philips. Philips marketed different product in its corporate name itself. That type of branding is known as corporate branding. The third category is individual branding. Individual branding means the firm make many products available in the market, but each product should have a unique brand name. For example, Hindustan Unilever introduced several products in the market with different brand name. For example, Surf Excel, Rin, Tide, etc. Now we are thinking about the fourth category of branding strategy, that is combination branding. In combination branding, we use a combination of corporate branding and individual branding. Here, the firm make available their product in the market with a combination of their corporate name and with the individual product name. For example, Microsoft Word. Here, the firm uses their corporate name, Microsoft, and the product name, Word, for branding that product. Microsoft Excel, Microsoft PowerPoint, Microsoft Paint, etc. are some other examples of combination branding. So these are the four different branding strategies or the types that the firms mainly adopted for branding their product in the market. Next area that we are going to discuss is the characteristics of a good brand. On the time of fixing a brand name, term, design or symbol, the firm want to consider some of the factors. Then only the brand should be attractive and effective and it reaches the minds of the customers. That are the factors that we are going to discuss in this area. First one is the brand should be easy to read and understand. Second one is it should be easy to pronounce. Then the third factor that the firm want to consider is it's suitable for the features of the product. Take the case of brand name Medimix. The brand name will suitable for the characteristics of that particular product that should be claimed by the firm. Then the next factor the firm want to remember is easy to memorize. The fifth character that the firm want to consider on the time of brand fixing is its uniqueness. Then the last one is legal stipulation. If we fix a brand name for their product, the firm must consider the rules and regulations and legal restriction that the nation established. In this session, we discussed about the branding, the term brand, the objectives of branding, and the different strategies adopted by the firms to conduct the branding activity and the characteristics of a good brand. I think all of you enjoy the session and get an idea about these things that we have discussed in these topics. Thank you.